Ernesto Jiménez. I'm the lead developer at SixStar. And I wanted to talk about five tips for HTML5 games, mainly for canvas performance. The points, those are five things that we have found useful while developing prototypes and some stuff on HTML5. And the first one is related to the game loop. So if anyone doesn't know what's the game loop, it's like in your game, in your HTML5 game, what you do is like you have an update function that processes the player input, updates the game logic, like according to the keys pressed, you change where the player is, and you draw everything in the screen. And you do a set timeout to call it often. The problem with the game loop is that drawing is the most expensive thing when you are doing HTML5 games with canvas. And the browser is locked while you are processing the JS, so while you are drawing and updating the whole logic and everything, the user cannot provide any input, and the browser is going to ignore any input from the user. And it's consuming resources, which is too bad for mobile games. So one of the things we learned is that you don't usually need a game loop for many games. If it's an arcade game, you are going to need to be updating everything continuously. But if it's a puzzle or something like that, with other technologies, you tend to do a game loop for anything. But with having the browser, which is event-driven, you can just react to the user input and draw on processes and input and update logic and draw stuff only when you need it. The other point is about frame buffering, which is supposed to be used for reduce flickering. The point with flickering is when you are drawing into the screen, if like you draw a rectangle first and you see the rectangle, and when you try to draw the second one, you see a flickering because it wasn't placed first. So the solution is using two cameras, one off screen and another visible. So you draw in the first canvas, and then when you have everything drawn, you move it to the visible canvas. And the right way to do it is with the drawing in the canvas that is off screen, and then draw an image using draw image and passing to the draw image the canvas instead of an image. There are some people around in the internet who told you that you should use like get image data and put image data, which get image data gives you an array with all the pixel information from the canvas, and you dump that into the canvas. The problem is that the performance from that solution is quite bad because get image data and put image data are very expensive. So if you want to use frame buffering, you should do it with the draw image from the canvas. And what we have noticed is that you usually don't need frame buffering because your browsers are not updating the canvas while you are running the JavaScript. So actually, if you start drawing tons of rectangles and then tons of the rectangles in the same place, like for a couple of seconds, and then try to draw a second one, the browser is not going to show the user anything until it has drawn everything. But actually, this about the, some people also say that it might be for the performance because drawing in the canvas off screen is faster than drawing in the canvas in screen. And I think this comes because in JavaScript performance, when you have to modify elements from the node, you usually want to do it off screen. But considering that canvas is not about you're not modifying the DOM tree or the rendering tree, you don't really need that. You don't really gain any performance by doing it off screen. Another thing that we have is like expensive drawing, get image data and put image data. People think it's great for doing pixel based, like setting the images to grayscale and stuff. If you need animations, it's going to kill your performance. When you are drawing, plain color is really, really great, but when you start using gradients and you start using blurred shadows, the performance goes like the latency goes to the roof. And like 3 milliseconds in the game loop might be a drop of 3 frames per second in the game. And fill text, which is really cool in Canvas because you can use CSS3 font space fonts that you declare in CSS, but it's really expensive and you should use it like only if you need it. Another thing we have learned is thinking outside of the canvas. At first we were drawing everything into one canvas, but then we realized that one game doesn't really mean one canvas, and that you can combine different canvas in the browser element to compose the image for the player. So for example, if you have here the like a space shooter, you could divide the game in different canvas so that you have like a canvas in the background that is not going to be drawn, so it's going to be it's not going to be a performance issue, a canvas for the player and a canvas for the all the aliens that are going to move together. So you just need to move the two canvas and you don't need to redraw the ship or the background, maybe the aliens if you want animation for the sprites. And the fifth thing is like when you start going into performance issues, that you should start learning about dirty rectangles. Dirty rectangles are in order to redraw only those parts of the screen that have changed. And what you do is like you have the bounding boxes defined for each element you have in the canvas. So when you have to when you're going to update the position or the sprite from a canvas, you mark it, that rectangle, that bounding box from the element as dirty. So for example here, if you wanted to move the spaceship to the left, you mark as dirty the previous position and the new position, and you just draw that part of the screen because the performance in the time it takes to draw depends on the amount of pixels you have to draw on the screen. So reducing the amount of drawing is good for the performance. And you have to actually declare dirty the position before and the position after, because otherwise you have this kind of effect where you have you are just redrawing the part where you get. And apart from that, if you want to learn about JavaScript performance, which is going to be useful if you have to do HTML5 arcade games, this book is really great. It's always tons of issues. And that's all. Questions?
Things that and Andre Lamothe and people were writing about 15 years ago, do you look back over those books and kind of find algorithms and nuggets to pull out and get squeeze every last nugget?
Yes, he was asking if you can go to all resources we have for developing games and apply them to new HTML games. You can do some stuff like the dirty rectangles, but not everything, because old games were code in assembler or really low-level code, so they got to do really tricky stuff with moving pixels in memory and things like that you cannot do in Canvas. Some things like dirty rectangles, this kind of stuff, you can apply, but some other things that are really low-level, you cannot apply them. Another question? That's, yeah.
Do you deal just with canvases, or do you use the DOM as well?
Yes, I use the DOM sometimes because, for example, we're doing a prototype with a thing that was really text heavy, and we had tons of text elements drawn. When you have tons of text elements with shadows, the performance drops, and you start have the frame rate drops really quite a lot. So what we did is like we were moving bunches of text together at the same speed, so we got the screen divided in layers, and we moved the layer. So you just have to draw all the text from one layer once, and then move the whole layer instead of moving the whole text. So you can combine DOM elements and canvas, but you have to take a look at your problem and apply it depending on the performance issues you have. That's all. Thank you.